Good morning. We're here at beautiful Bays Mountain Park. We're with naturalist Megan. And good morning, Megan.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. It's good to see you this
good
morning.
Good to see you, too.
And we're actually getting ready for a barge ride. But Megan, how long have you actually been with Bays Mountain and been with parks with your job?
For Bays Mountain, I'm going on 5 years. But parks in general, I have been in the system for over 20 years. I spent 17 years working with Virginia State Parks, and then 6 years prior to that, I worked with Michigan State Parks. So I've been in the system, the park system, and wearing a uniform of sort for almost over 20 years.
And as far as the barge itself, how many barge rides do you all do on a daily basis?
During the week, we have 3 barge rides that will take place, 10:30, 1 o'clock, and 3 o'clock. On the weekends, on Saturday and Sunday, we have barge rides that will take place at 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Okay. And what is the capacity of the barge as far as the number of people who can ride it?
When you look around the barge, you're thinking, wow, this is
That's a very huge vessel here.
And pre-COVID-19, we could get roughly about 45 individuals on the barge. But after COVID-19, we look at 9 individuals due to social distancing practices.
Well, it's quite a large barge, that's for sure. And so how did you, did you have any experience with driving barges before coming here and actually driving one?
So in my previous life, I actually was a kayak and a canoe tour guide. And so I'm accustomed to vessels that you have to power yourself. So coming here and looking at this large barge, I thought to myself, oh, this is going to be interesting. So roughly about 5 years later, I'm now feeling comfortable with driving such a large vessel. Thank goodness we're the only ones on the water, that's for sure. But it was a little bit daunting. I had some great individuals that trained me on how to, you know, get the barge up to the dock and driving the barge and how to angle the barge when there's wind and so forth. So, but all in all, after, you know, those 4 years, I feel a little bit more confident now in my driving abilities.
Yeah, well, we appreciate you showing us around the beautiful lake here, and thank you so much. Hope you have a great day.
Well, thanks, you too, and we appreciate the opportunity, and I hope you guys have a great time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you. So the pavilion on your left-hand side was constructed in 2017 and it was opened to the public in 2018. And it's the pavilion at Lily Pad Cove. And pre-COVID-19, you could get up to 80 individuals on that pavilion. After COVID-19, we're only allowed 10. Unfortunately.
Is there, do people like use that for weddings and things?
Correct. Weddings, birthday parties, family reunions, and so forth. If somebody wanted to get their pictures taken for any type of event that they want or announcements or anything like that. So it can be used for multiple purposes. It does have electricity. We have outlets in the floor. And Monday through Thursday for a 4-hour time block, the cost is $150. And then Friday through Sunday for a 4-hour time block, $250 for the rental fee. Now this morning it's nice and calm, so not quite sure what we're going to be able to see this morning. We have a variety of animals that do come out to the water's edge from time to time. Thank you.
have to be 55 years of age or older, or younger than 15 years of age. And if you're 55 years or older, you have to have a state fishing license. And you can fish from the dam Monday through Saturday from 8:30 in the morning to noon time. No live bait.
Thank you.
We are a nature preserve. We like to keep things as natural as possible around the reservoir. Also, if we were to remove those trees, we're actually destroying habitat. Some of the animals that like to use those trees are fish. And we have largemouth bass, channel catfish. We also have sunfish, bluegill, oarmouth, and then we also have mosquito fish that live in this reservoir.
Temperatures start to increase, so has the magnitude of the water shield.
grow in about 9 feet of water or less. And they have an intricate root system down below in the reservoir. Now for a 44-acre lake or reservoir, we should have an abundance of fish, but we actually do not. And the reasoning for that is because of these water shields. The water shields are extracting a lot of the nutrients that the fish need in order to survive. Also, if you look on your right-hand side, up on shore in the shadows, we have a couple of deer. Another type of lily pad is called the bullhead lily pad, and it's much thicker and bigger than the water shields. The bullhead lily pad has a yellow bloom that looks like a golf ball, and it looks like it's getting ready to open up, but it's actually in full bloom. Now, these particular lily pads happen to dwindle because the water shields are choking out the bullhead lily pads. An animal that eats the bullhead lily pads are the beavers. The bullhead lily pads provide a really great food source, high in nutrients for the beavers themselves, whereas the water shields do not provide as much nutrients for them. As we make our way into this cove, keep your eyes open to the lily pads. You may see a snapping turtle or two. Great location for our resident snappy turtles. Nice and shady underneath the lily pads. Cool. They don't have any major predators besides our crop that comes up through this area. Off on your right hand side at roughly about your 1 o'clock, underneath the grouping of trees here, and just to the left of the dead hemlock here, there's a pile of sticks on shore. And that pile of sticks is a good indication that which we call all of it is on shore. After a period of time, he finally figured out, hey, wait a minute, I'm not close enough to the water. I need to stop this project and go someplace else because I need to have at least an entrance hole so I can get in and out of my lodge. Locations throughout the park where beavers have made dams, they have caused destruction to some of our trails, so we've had to figure out how to cohabitate with beavers. We have not found the correct recipe for that quite yet. around lakes and rivers. And beavers were actually introduced to Bays Mountain around 1971. And roughly around 49 years later, we're dealing with that wonderful release. So how many beavers we have here on the property, we're not quite sure. But we can see remnants of where we've had beaver activity. Now, off on your right-hand side, when you're looking along the edge here, you'll notice that there are, looks like, trails that will go on up into this little island here. And those particular trails are what we call beaver slides. Beavers will utilize those trails, go on up to the trees, gnaw down some tasty trees that they happen to find up in the woodline area. Now, some of the trees that they will chew on are your softer woods, like your tulip poplars and your willows. Now, sometimes they'll chew on oak trees. As you can see, a few of the oak trees do have some escarpment at the bottom of the tree, but it appears the tree has not fallen over quite yet. Oak is a hard wood, and they have a tendency to, after a period of time, get kind of bored with chewing on such a hard wood. Now, beavers will eat the cambium layer, which is the a layer on the inside of the bark, and that cambium layer provides a great food or fat source for them. Anywhere from 235,000 to 240,000, depending on the year. So somewhere in that range. Pretty good for a park that doesn't provide camping. Now, we have primitive camping here at the park. A lot of our Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts will utilize to get badges and so forth, but we do not have any type of modern camping.
crabs. What kind of fish here in the lake?
We have channel catfish, largemouth bass. We also have sunfish, bluegill, warmouth, and mosquito fish. Directly in front of us, you can see the cormorant just barely sticking its head out in the water. Oh, he just went underneath the water. Over the top of it would be nice to be a cormorant right about now. Jumping into that water. Woo! Real good.
What the temperature of the water is?
It's like bath water.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.